8 years after the Guantanamo Detention Center opened, there are now new images of detainees looking peaceful and pious. Does this put new pressure on the White House? And Senate Democratic Leader Harry Reid says he's apologized enough for racial remarks he made during the presidential campaign. If the president's not offended, why are some Republicans so outraged? I'm Wolf Blitzer. You're in the Situation Room. Eight years after the detention center opened at Guantanamo Bay, new images are emerging of terror suspects looking peaceful and pious. Does that represent a new headache for the Obama administration? Brian Todd is here. He's been looking into this. Brian, what are we seeing and hearing?
Well, new images, Wolf, some we had gotten a couple of years ago, some that we're seeing for the first time today. As Wolf mentioned, the eighth anniversary of the day those first detainees arrived at Guantanamo. Some images from today are hitting home the political difficulty the White House is facing in trying to close the facility. He looks serene and thoughtful as he kneels in prayer. This photograph, previously obtained by CNN, is of alleged 9/11 mastermind Khalid Sheikh Mohammed at the detention facility at Guantanamo Bay. A sharp contrast from the image of his capture in Pakistan a few years earlier. This is one of several photographs just printed by the Miami Herald of current and former detainees at Guantanamo. The Herald got the photos from families of the detainees. They were taken by the international community of the Red Cross. Some of these men are smiling, but it's not clear why. Al-Qaeda analyst Jarrett Brackman, who helped CNN obtain some of the photographs from an Arabic website, says this is another example of the complexity of the war on terror.
I think the hard part here is that they all kind of look like pious Muslims, some of whom were picked up for, you know, being in the wrong place, wrong time. Others planned 9/11. And so trying to figure out who is really bad, you know, among them and who's not is very complicated. And that's precisely Al-Qaeda's goal.
Another photo posted by the Herald, which CNN had obtained from the Arabic website, is of Khalid Sheikh Mohammed's nephew, Omar al-Baluchi, holding up the Quran. The Herald released these images to coincide with the eighth anniversary of the detention center's opening.
Detainees down!
That, along with this protest at the White House by a group representing current detainees, illustrates the political dilemma for the White House as it tries to close Guantanamo. An attorney for one detainee, whose transfer back to Yemen was halted by the Obama administration, says the White House should have been working harder to reintegrate these men back in their home countries if it was concerned about security.
Energy should go towards providing support services, providing compensation, providing a framework that would allow people who are being returned to reintegrate successfully. Certainly that's needed. These men have been through 8 years of trauma.
But that takes time to set up, right?
That the administration has had a year to look at these cases.
An administration official told us today the president is as committed now as he's ever been to closing Guantanamo. But White House officials also say they have to continue their review of each case to determine the security risks and how these detainees will be dealt with once they're transferred. Wolf, that went into, of course, that decision to halt for now those transfers of the detainees to Yemen.
And the Obama administration is still taking some new heat over its plans to transfer some of those detainees from Gitmo to a maximum security prison in Illinois.
They're taking heat from the left on that and from the right. An administration official told us today that they are committed to working toward security at that Thompson Correctional Facility in Illinois. Specifically, they want to make it more secure than that Supermax facility in Colorado, where they add no inmate has ever escaped.
Brian Tata on the story for us, as he always is. Thank you, Brian. There are 198 detainees remaining at Guantanamo Bay at the detention center there in Cuba. More than 90 of them are from Yemen. 21 Yemenis have been released from Guantanamo, 14 of them during the Bush administration, 7 during the Obama administration. In all, the Bush administration transferred 532 Gitmo detainees. 42 have been moved out by the Obama administration over the past year.